Hello everyone, I'm happy to meet you all through this video, and I hope this video is going to be really useful for 10th grade children of CBSE. In my last video, I have shared the summary of this chapter, A Letter to God, written by G.L. Fuentes, and this video is also related to the same chapter, but not the summary. Okay, so firstly, we are going to see the character analysis. Here only the two major characters involved in this chapter. Let's see. The first one is Lencho, and he's a farmer and a hardworking person, and he has strong faith in God, because sometimes they may ask a question about this character Lencho, what kind of person he is, maybe ask. So just a small introduction about this poor farmer. He's a farmer and a hardworking man, and he has strong faith in God. And the next character involved in this chapter is the postmaster, right? And he is a friendly and pleasant character. And the writer has used a very good word to describe the postmaster's nature. Is an amiable person who is very friendly in nature, and he is a man of good spirits. Like as he has decided to help this poor farmer in order to appreciate his strong faith, that shows his very good spirits, right? So these are the two characters involved in this chapter. And next, we shall see a few more grammar items here. So, here the writer has used a few of collective nouns. Already you might have studied in your lower class what is collective noun, right? Yeah, let's see. A few of collective nouns are also used here. What is it? In our lower classes, we might have studied so many collective nouns. A bunch of keys, a bunch of grapes, and then a crew of sailors, like that. Here also the two collective nouns are used. Let's see, one is a plague of locusts, which means insects. Actually they are insects. They are generally insects, but they come as large groups, maybe thousands and even lakhs of insects. They come together to destroy all the fields, especially the crops. And even recently it happened in Pakistan, like you might have noticed, or you might have heard the news, right? A plague of locusts, they completely destroyed the crops of many thousands of acres in Pakistan recently. So generally, these insects, they come as large groups. They eat all the crops, including the leaves and the flowers, everything they eat, and they leave only the rest, right? In that case also, the farmers are in problem again. They won't get the good harvest that season, right? So, a plague of locusts, it's a collective noun, because this word here, the plague stands for, it's a big group. And the next thing, the second one is, yeah, bunch of crooks. A bunch of crooks. Crooks, which means a criminal or a cheater. Here a bunch of crooks means it's a collective noun. There, according to Lencho, the people who are working in post office, and all the employees of a post office, according to him, is bunch of crooks, because he suspected that they have taken the remaining 30 pesos. He received only 70 pesos, whereas the 30 are missing. So Lencho believed that may be taken away by his crooks. So these are the two collective nouns used in this chapter. So do remember that. Next. Apart from these all, this writer Fuentes, and he used various comparisons here, right? from the beginning to end of the story, he used various comparisons. Let's see what are those comparisons here. Okay. Firstly, he described Lencho as an ox of a man. What is that? An ox of a man. So here he compares this Lencho with ox, because he is such a hard worker. He works very hard in his field. He is fully involved in his work. That sort of farmer he is. That's why he described Lencho as an ox of a man. Here Lencho is compared with an animal, such kind of strong, physically strong and mentally strong, and moreover, and like a domestic animal, he could do all the work for his field. Such a kind of man he is. So this Lencho is compared with an ox of a man. And next comparison. He compares the rain droplets. I think you might have remembered my word. This 5 cent coins are compared with 5 cent coins are compared with small droplets. Small rain droplets. Same way. This 10 cents coin, 5 cents coins are compared with the small droplets, and same way the 10 cent coins are compared with the big sized rain droplets. And the third comparison, the hailstones. I told you what is hailstones, and those hailstones are compared with the frozen pearls. Have you seen pearls? In many of the movies, they show some crystal-like stones, right? That, yeah, the same kind of appearance this real hailstones has, and they have the same appearance. And those hailstones are compared with frozen pearls. And fourth comparison, is the employees of postmaster. They are compared with the crooks. So these are the main comparisons that we can see in this chapter. And finally, a few vocabulary. Regarding comparison, I forgot to tell you one more thing. Here, even the agricultural field, I mean the corn field, the ripe corn, with along with its flowers, seemed to be like a curtain, a screen spread out in over the fields in the entire valley. Even that comparison is also made. Just do remember.